I was a child in the 1960s, and it was a time of great technological progress and great excitement about technologies. Perhaps the biggest example at the time was manned space travel. It was a time when the first astronauts were going into space, and when I grew up, I was clear that I wanted to be an astronaut. The other image of technological progress was robots, and at this time they were mostly robots in fiction, and on television when I was a child, growing up, there were many of these. However, there are many earlier depictions of robots in fiction. Perhaps the first one is the character Maria from the 1927 movie Metropolis. The robot Gort from the 1951, the original make of the movie The Day the Earth Stood Still. And then there's perhaps my all-time favourite robot, Robbie, from the movie Forbidden Planet in 1956, and he appeared in a number of other follow-up movies. Without doubt, the two most famous fictional robots are these two from the original Star Wars movie, which debuted in 1977, R2-D2 and his talkative friend C-3PO. These two characters depict robots as being benign, that is, helpful to the people around them, and also as being incredibly intelligent, able to hold conversations in human languages, and being able to perform complex engineering tasks like hacking a Death Star. This more recent movie, Robot and Frank, depicts a very plausible future where an old person is being assisted in their daily life by a helper robot. And this is a robot that is humanoid in form, is able to converse with the main character Frank in natural language, guide him to eat better, and to change some of his bad habits. However, all the robots that we see in fiction are just that, they are fiction. So the robot from the Metropolis movie way back in 1927 was indeed a human being inside a metallic suit. And you think, well, that's probably not surprising. The technology back in 1927 was really pretty primitive. But it hasn't actually changed much. In the 1950s, Robbie the robot was also a human being inside a large metallic suit. And so it goes. Even in the original Star Wars movies, C-3PO was the actor Anthony Daniels inside a gold metallic suit. And so it also was for R2-D2, the actor Kenny Baker inside R2-D2. Since the beginning of the Star Wars movie franchise, very many, many other movies have come out and introduced us to particular robot characters, and some of their names are depicted here as a function of time. In fact, you might be surprised how many robots you think you know or recognize, and I love this particular cartoon by Richard Sargent, which shows a wide range of fictional robots, and it's an interesting exercise to go through this and see how many robots you can recognize in this scene, and the solutions are available on the web. In addition to all the portrayals of robots in television and movies, there have also been a large number of books, science fiction books, which based on the theme of robots and the interactions between robots and humanity, both good interactions and bad interactions. The word robot itself is a Czech word, and it means something like worker or slave, and it was coined in a 1920 play by the Czech playwright Karel Čapek. His play was titled Rossum's Universal Robots, or RUR. The theme of the play is that people create robots to relieve them of the drudgery of everyday physical work. The robots eventually get to resent their role in society as being the ones who do all the work. They rise up, they rebel, and they kill the human beings. So this is a very recurrent theme in many, many robot movies being made to this very day. And we can think of it perhaps as a reinterpretation of the story Frankenstein from at least 100 years before this. I had the opportunity to be in Prague a few years ago, and I went and paid my respects to Karel Čapek. I went and visited his grave, and the photograph is shown here, and I was delighted to see that somebody had left a small model robot on his headstone, and I wish that I had thought of doing that myself. Perhaps the author who has done the most to popularize the idea of robots in fiction is Isaac Asimov, a very, very prolific American writer of science fiction. A key element of almost all of Asimov's stories are his laws of robotics. In the robots in his stories, these laws were embedded in the positronic brain of every robot. The robots were incapable of violating any of these laws. And if you look at these laws at face value, they all make a lot of sense. though most of Asimov's stories, there was always some wrinkle or corner case in the implementation of the laws, the way the laws interacted with human beings or with other robots.